Good morning. My name is Grażyna Liczbińska, and on behalf of my colleague Janusz Piątek from the Department of Anthropology, Adam Mickiewicz University in Poznań, we want to focus your attention on old, means classical, paleodemographic methods and new methodology in research on state of the and the dynamics of prehistoric populations, in this case on Wicina population. And what the idea, the problem is that there is a group of critics of paleodemographic research because of inaccuracy of sex determination or age determination. There is also lack of data according to age. The material size we focus on is usually lower, so no adequate representation of material because of what? Of lack of child skeletal remains. So the real population size was probably higher, greater. And that's why researchers have omitted the classical methodology and search for new methodological approach, for new solutions. So, for example, they reject classical life table, building of life tables. So this is the aim of the presentation, to show old methodological approach and new methods. And I show you that the results produced using both are the same. Material we focus on were human remains excavated in 1950s and 60s at Wicina Cemetery. We use over 400 individuals with age and sex determined. So that's the urn field from Wicina. More information will be provided by Justyna during our common presentation at 12. So over slightly over 500 graves and 438 individual information on people died. And methodology, classical methods were used, so we built life tables, classical life tables, classical Halley's life table for stationary population model, without and with the correction of the number of children. As we know, the stationary population model with the assumption that fertility and mortality balance each other is a kind of oversimplification. That's why we introduce population growth. It's quite difficult to calculate the value of population growth for prehistoric populations, so we adopt the values from model tables produced by Wise, and also I calculated them from a regression line, regression function of Bockert-Appel. On the basis of life table parameters, we estimated fertility parameters, fertility figures, and we assessed the selection pressure. And new methods, new methodology, the Kaplan-Meier survival function, which leads us to omit the under-registration of individuals, of children age 0-14, and Cox proportional hazard models, which will be shown during the noon presentation, how to capture, for example, the impact of some cultural variables on age of death. And computation statistics was used then, how to calculate information, how to calculate fertility on the basis of life table parameters and population growth were calculated on the basis of methodology provided by Kenneth Wise first, and then it was developed by Henneberg and Stein, published in paper in Human Biology, Bockert-Appel function from current anthropology, and then classical cross index, Henneberg and Piątek's papers on how to assess measures of the opportunity for natural selection. Having age estimated, we grouped people in age categories, children and adult age categories. As we know, adult would start at the age of 15. And what the pros and cons of the use of life tables, which are sometimes criticized? The problem concerns the methodology. There are two methods. First, on the basis of age of population, which is used by, for example, contemporary demographers, but Also with regard to 19th century populations, when we have distribution of people by age, I built such life tables for 19th century population from Poland. But when you focus on skeletal remains, prehistoric remains, there is no data on age, on population by age. That's why the only information on population are distribution of disease by age. According to many anthropologists, the distribution of those who died by age do not represent the real age structure. That's why this method is criticized, this life tables. Some paleodemographists, anthropologists, Gage, Lovejoy, they propose to, for example, use hazard methods, which from my point of view, as I am an anthropologist, a biologist, quite complicated to interpret the results produced with the use of such methods. I belong to the group who still use life tables. We, for example, calculate life table parameters using both methods. So on the basis of distribution of those who died and on the basis of population, by age, and differences in life table parameters for the same population, the same period, were statistically insignificant. So no differences in my opinion, the most informative parameter, which is life expectancy at age zero. This slide presents life expectancy for two model situations. As you can see, the results up to the age of 15 are grouped in two groups, with first marked with blue line, when the number of children was underrepresented, and second with red lines, with correction of number of children. Differences concerns what? The fact that the number of children was underrepresented, so that's why the only fact influencing the results. So in the first situation, life expectancy at the age of zero was at close to 12, while in the second one, close to 30. When you introduce the value of population growth, the values change a little because of what? Of the fact that population growth was very small. It was 1.7 or 2.2 according to methods of population growth calculation per 1,000 people. So MT means model table of Wise, 17.565 means life expectancies, probability of surviving at the age of 15. Fraction of dying, also two groups of lines according to the fact if children were corrected or not. But what is characteristic is the fact that the higher fraction of dying was up the age of one, and then between the age of 30 and 40. Irrespective of the fact if children were correct or not. And fraction of surviving, which declining with age, and also two groups of lines. Fertility reconstruction. Kenneth Wise was the first who implemented these methods or tried to estimated fertility figures on the basis of life table parameters and population growth. I did the same, for example, for 19th century population from Greater Poland because of having a lack of information on fragmentary information on children born to women. That way it was impossible to reconstruct the reproductive histories of women. And in such situations, this method is very useful. So three population models with zero population growth and non-zero population growth, first adopted from model tables of Wise and then calculated on the basis of Bockert-Appel regression. As you can see, the fertility figures are almost the same. So the same value of average age-specific fertility rate, mean birth interval, mean family size. But I would like to focus your attention on total fertility rate, which informs us about how many children were delivered by women during their whole reproductive period, which is between 15 and the age of 49. So the values are close to 6 and slightly over 6. And the question is high or not. What if the number of children is 5, is the value high? or not. It depends, because, for example, the same values were obtained for 19th century population from Poland. But the majority of children born died before the reaching of the onset of reproduction. So, which is confirmed by the opportunity for natural selection, the measures informing us about the selection pressure. Here we have, they are also calculated on the basis of life tail parameters. That's why, in my opinion, life tails are extremely valuable, because they lead to recalculate or calculate completely different parameters. First, growth index, extremely high in the situation when the number of children was collected, 1.5, which means that the mortality of children, infants, young children was very high. So quite a high selection pressure against children. Then potential reproductive growth, which informs us about the selection pressure according adults. So in this case, 51% of the adult population had a chance to produce children, because the majority of them did not survive the onset of reproduction. And biological state index, which informs us about the participation in producing children in the whole population. And here, between 20 and 35% of the population has a chance to participate in producing children. So high selection pressure against infants and children translated into low chance to participate in reproduction, because the majority of children did not survive the onset and the reproduction, and few people survived to the end of reproduction. For comparison, Poland, the 1960s, and the potential reproductive growth was equal 0.99. The biological state index was equal 0.99, which means that in Poland in 1960s, when the excavations at Wycina Cemetery was conducted, the 99% of the population had a chance to participate in reproduction. So that's the difference. And finally, survival probability, Kaplan-Meier function. I focus more, I tell more about this method in the next presentation. It is quite useful because when our material is partially known, here we have a group of people with lower age, lower limits of the age at death. So it's very useful when you want to omit the under-registration of deaths, and what kind of information is provided with a survival probability. For example, the onset of maturity, the age of 15 conventionally, 50% of individuals survived up to the age of 15. And for example, to the age of 40, about 25% of people. And the results are common or are covered with the survival line or survival probability, which is produced with the use of life table, classical life table. So the results are almost the same. So what the conclusion that paleodemographic research, I mean the classical paleodemographic research, which were developed in 1970s, 80s, are still a very important part of studies. So there are still very important tools in research on skeletal populations, on prehistoric populations. Of course, it's worth searching for new methodology under the condition that the results we are produced with the use of them are easy to interpret from the point of view of biology, since we are talking about the state and dynamics, and biological dynamics of a given population. So thank you very much for your attention.